Most people leave their growth up to chance, usually because they just don't think they have the time. And so they're either just trying to learn from what's happening around them, which is a good thing, or they're kind of haphazardly developing themselves based on whatever book happens to interest them right now. And then 5 years goes by, or rather the same year goes by 5 times in a row, and their random efforts created random results. If you want more than random results, let's talk about how to create a personal development plan that is specific, sustainable, and moves you forward in the right direction. The first and most important thing you need to do is start from the end. If you don't know your target, you don't know how to aim. So where do you want to be in 10 years' time? This can be personal, professional, relational, financial. And if you don't know 100% right now, that's okay. You don't need it to be perfect right now in order to get started, and I'll explain why towards the end of this video. You do need to know the general direction though, and some questions to help you get there would be, who do you need or want to be 10 years from now? What do you want life to be in 5 or 10 years? What will life need you to be? What will the future ask of you? And who will you need to be in order to even get there? Everyone's answers are going to be different based on where you want to go and where you're starting from, but some examples might be things like your health. If you know that your health is not heading in the right trajectory to where you want to be in 10 years, that might be something that you're addressing now. Another example might be personality or character traits. You know that who you get to be in 10 years is a lot more patient than who you are right now. You might also be looking at things like habits or the skills that are necessary or that will be necessary to you in the future, whether that's marketing skills, business skills, leadership skills, communication skills. Make this list for yourself, but don't let yourself feel overwhelmed. Chances are, like most people, where you are is pretty far off from where you want to be. Your goal here, though, is to figure out what are your top 3 needle movers, the top 3 things that if you focused on these first, they would make the biggest impact, maybe they would influence the most other things, or maybe they're just foundational. They're the things that you know need to be in place before anything else can start moving. Comment below and let me know one of your top 3 personal development needle movers. What do you know you most need to be focusing on right now for where you want to be 5 to 10 years down the road? The next step is to reverse engineer this. So if you have a 10-year vision, I want you to ask yourself, where would I need to be in 5 years? Where would I need to be in 3 years, in 2 years, in 1 year, in 6 months, in 90 days? No matter where you start from, I want you to reverse step it backwards until you get to 90 days. Where do I need to be? What do I need to be focusing on? What skills need to be in place? What habits should I have implemented in these next 90 days to know that I am moving in the right direction towards my long-term vision? The next part of this personal development plan is to figure out when and where you're actually going to do this, to make time to be able to focus on your goals. And I just did a video last week on how to find time for your goals that is very specific, actionable, step by step to show you exactly how to move your schedule around to be able to make some space for these things that matter in the long run. It's very easy to think, I don't need this now, I can wait. But the more you put it off, the more you are delaying that 10-year vision. One of the biggest problems that most people have and the reason why they never reach their goals is because they think they have more time than they actually do. They think they either have more time in their week or they think they have years to figure something out. And they don't realize that unless they get started now, unless you start chipping away at it now, it will never actually come to fruition. If you're not taking action on it, how can it?
Hey bosses, different Tara here, interrupting this video with a very important message. If you know that you have been getting in your own way when it comes to your goals, meaning you've got projects or ideas that you've been sitting on, maybe out of overwhelm or procrastination, or even just not finding the time in your busy life, but you're ready to figure out how to make them happen with coaching,
with strategies, with the support and the energy and the accountability of other amazing like-minded women, then I want to invite you to my 100% free 5-day Get Out of Your Own Way challenge. We're going to be hosting this in just a few weeks. I'm still ironing out the details, but I wanted to let you know because if you want first dibs on the information as soon as it comes available, be sure to sign up in the waiting list or on the waiting list in the description below. Make sure that you're also subscribed to this channel and that way you will not miss a beat. Until then, I will return you to our regularly scheduled programming. Number 4 is to schedule the steps to success. I had a coach tell me years ago that success is scheduled. It's on your calendar and it's specific. So what are the specific steps, the specific habits that you can consistently do over the next 90 days that are going to move you towards that goal? More importantly, what is the most active, the most engaging, the most fun and exciting habit that you can implement in that time? So fun is probably pretty self-explanatory, but what I mean by active and engaging is something that will get you out of your head and into your body or into the real world. Let's say, for example, in 10 years, you know you need to be an expert communicator. One habit could be to read books on communication, but that's not a very active, engaging habit. Maybe instead you're going to join a meetup group or a Toastmasters group, something that will allow you to engage with other people out in the real world, putting what you're learning into place. The books are great, but how can you actively engage with the skills that you're trying to develop? So again, we are outlining our specific steps, our specific actions that we're going to take, but then we're actually getting them on our calendar now. The next thing you need to do is the thing that so many people miss. You need to schedule time to check in, to track your habits, to track your progress, to reassess your goals and the things that are moving you towards those goals. Action creates clarity. So over the next 90 days and even the 90 days following and the 90 days following, you're going to gain more and more clarity about the direction that you need to go. Having a time to check in every 90 days to make sure that you're still on track, to make sure that your habits are still moving in the right direction, or if not, to do the course correction necessary to get you moving forward again is crucial. We don't have enough quiet space in our life to sit down and really assess what's working, what's not working, and where are we going. It's very easy to fall into the habit of taking action that actually ends up veering slightly off course. I actually create this time once a quarter, once a month, once a week, and every day. That sounds like a lot of time, right? But it's really not. It's about 3 minutes at the beginning and end of every day. It's about 15 minutes at the end of every week. It's about maybe an hour, up to an hour a month. And every quarter, it's also about 1 to 2 hours tops. I actually just did a video last month on how I track my progress on my goals in a daily habit journal. You can find the link for that in the description. Creating your own personal development plan in this way ensures that you're creating something that is specific to your needs, to where you want to be in 10 years, and not just what other people are doing or what sounds good from other people. Getting it on your calendar and having time to check in with it ensures that you're able to sustain it and keep yourself on track. One thing that I highly recommend you make sure is on this plan is your own mindset. Where are your emotions at? Where do they need to be? Where are your thoughts at? Your beliefs at? Where do they need to be? Who do you need to be? What do you need to be believing, doing, feeling capable of in 10 years? All of that comes down to our mindset. And if you are wondering how to tackle your mindset, what does that include? What do you need to be focusing on? Make sure you grab my free training below. It's called Bottlenecks to Breakthroughs, and it will show you the only 5 things you need to focus on in order to up-level the mindset that will allow you to reach those goals. By the way, if you're brand new here, my name is Tara Wagner. I'm a belief breakthrough coach helping women to crush their goals, not their soul. And if you would love support in overcoming the limiting beliefs, the bad habits that are holding you back, be sure to subscribe, hit the bell for notifications, give this video a thumbs up, and leave me a comment letting me know what else you would love to see from this channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Really? Can you see that bug? Always, man. It's like... I think I got it. Stupid fruit flies. I didn't get it. Where'd it go?